spend too much time talking to you guys, because my story is not important. What's important for me is to give you enough information for you to be successful in whatever you want to do. Entrepreneurship is not for everybody, guys. I can tell you that myself. It's lonely. It's a lonely road. It's challenging. Most of your friends and family will not believe in you. It's a fact. And the next thing you know, you quit. But you'll never know. Imagine if I quit years back. I wouldn't be here talking to you guys. You know, imagine if I stopped chasing my dream 5, 6, 7 years ago. I wouldn't be here talking to you guys. See, I didn't quit because I knew deep inside, as long as I continue to fight, something good will come out. You know, of course, it's hard work, it's dedication. So the first thing I want to make sure that you understand is business is the hardest thing you probably will experience in your life. If you prepare your mind for that, the rest is less stressful. But a lot of time I see young men and women, they start business and think it's easy. They do all I have to do is register, go this, do that, okay, now customers will come. Customers don't come 1 month, 2 months, 3 months, they lose momentum, they quit, and it's over, it's done. Another tool I will give you is, guys, is you guys are the luckiest group of, the youth of today are very lucky. Why? Because you have access to the internet. When I started business, there was no internet. Or it was very, it was not as developed as it is today. Now you can get all the information you need on the internet. You can Google it, you can YouTube it. So don't waste time waiting for people like me or all that. Do research. You have to do your research before you even get started. You need to know your competition. That's very important. You need to know what your competition is doing. Because there's two ways to make money in business. In any business you want, you either bring an innovative product that nobody has, but the customer needs. Or if you have a product that you have competition, then you have to have a better pricing for. Basically, your price has to be better than your competition. And your service that you give to that customer has to be better than your competition. Because a customer is not going to leave one company for another and they're offering the same services and the same client. No, it has to be something plus than the other guy. That's the only two ways you can succeed in business. You know, so you have to know where you are. You said real estate. That's a perfect example. So do you have an idea how you're going to market your real estate? How old are you? Okay. Another thing I've learned is be patient, guys. Be patient. Patience is key in business. Nothing happened in 1 year, 2 years. It takes years and years of practice, of failure to succeed. They say the average company failed 3 times, or the average individual failed 3 times before he succeeded. And another thing I want to say, try to look for partners. It's easier to work as a team than, and you don't need a lot of partners. One partner that has the same mindset as you. It's easier to do it together. If I had to do it again, I'll look for a partner. I built everything myself, and that was extremely hard. But entrepreneurship, to start entrepreneurship is a young game, meaning it's a young person's game. Because you're going to fail, you're going to have a lot of failure, you're going to have a lot of rejection, a lot of no's, but at least as you're young, you grow and you learn. You know, so this is the best time. Again, I started at 21, so this is the best time, this is the right time. But don't be so hard on yourself. Expect that you will fail. Expect that. You know? Don't take it personal. Don't let people make fun of you. That's okay. That's okay.
What would you consider, like, from any point, if you wanted to impress someone, what first character would you consider?
The first thing I look at for an employee is how they solve problems. Problem solving is my number one goal. I'd rather hire somebody as didn't go to college, but is very good at solving problems, and somebody went to college and don't know how to solve it. And this is the biggest problem with students today in Northern, and in Africa in general. They go to school, and I don't blame students, I blame really the school system. It's really a school system problem. They teach people how to follow rules. They don't teach people how to think outside the box. You know, they don't teach people how to think from a solved problem on their own. Don't use excuses. If you fail, you fail. It's you, your fault. If you succeed, it's you. You succeed because of you. You know? Don't give nobody no excuse. Don't give yourself no excuse. You don't deserve them. You should be honest with yourself. When I used to fail, I used to look at myself in the mirror every morning and ask myself, why? Why is this happening to me? I used to think it was God intervening and trying to make me fail, or maybe I was not meant to be successful. But then I had to catch myself. I had to, you know, refocus. I had to tell myself, no, no, what excuse am I giving myself? It's me. I have to continue to fight. Nobody's going to fight for me. Nobody's going to fight for you guys. Nobody. Your parents are here to feed you, pay for your school fees. When you're 18, that's it. You're a man or you're a woman. You shouldn't expect anything from nobody. Now you are responsible for your own success. And your success or your failure start now. Not 10 years from now, not 20 years from now. You start your idea, your goal, your vision, whatever you want to do, you start today. Don't get lost into the fun. Yeah, have fun, enjoy the youth, that's great. But think about your future. Because time is the case. So plan for your future, take things seriously. And learn as much as you can, and execute, and take action. Who's going to college? You're not going to college? University, right? Everybody?
Yeah.